Let's color the penguins. You can use watercolor or you can use your color pencil, and it doesn't matter if you want to color it. And we always, no matter watercolor or color pencil, we always color from the dark to light, to dark. So I'm mixing a blue background because I'm not using watercolor paper, so I can't really put too much water on this paper. If you put too much water on this paper, it's going to be wrinkled, okay? So not too much water on the paper. Not put too much water on the paper. It's not watercolor paper. Watercolor paper won't wrinkle that much. So I'm just color like this. I'm not filling like all the papers. Just like that. Maybe I get like more brighter in the front. Brighter color in the front. Okay, and it's a wrinkle in the bottom. Okay, a little bit color there. Then I'm going to start with the rice part. The rice part is this blue, but I think it would be too blue. I'm going to add some yellow because it looks like a little greenish color. But I don't want it too bright because it's shadow, right? So I'm just mixing them up. Some dirt part of my, so kind of like that color. See, I'm shading it, the shadow part. You can tell that's the lighter part, that's the shadow part. It's kind of that color. Just dab it. Same thing, this is a shadow from this casting shadow from there. Now I'm going to get a little bit darker layer on here, like on the side. Add a little bit darker shadow somewhere. Not everywhere, but find the right place. Shadow. kind of greenish blue. It's greener than that, right? Leave white. This is more orange color, right? So you're not to try to make it flat. So the color on your brush doesn't need to be like consistent, you know, some part going to be dark, some part going to be light, or different color is fine. You don't need the consistency of the color. So I think you need more yellow that part. Then this is the darker part. Because it's bumpy, so you don't want to color it flat, right? Because it's bumpy. Not watercolor paper, so it looks weird. Okay, I'm going to do the color the cup bridge. Remember, leave white. For watercolor, always thinking about leaving white. See, I didn't use a black. I used the ultramarine blue. If I want a darker, you mixing with this red. Don't be a very darker color. Ultramarine blue plus white? No, ultramarine blue plus red. So make a very darker color. So I'm not using black. It's not all black, okay? And some parts is lighter. Tomato. Some yellow in there. Then I put red on top. So this is a potato salad. Find a color for the shadow of the potato salad. It's kind of the shadow, the color of shadow of the potato salad. Then potato salad has some green and that's more like green, that's too blue. Green and I think it's carrots in there. Okay. And the end, I want to emphasize the plate, making a shadow. Emphasize some shadow under the penguin. Felt like the shrimp need a little bit darker color somewhere. Here's your penguin.